Late Night Health continues. I'm Mark Allen. I've been a bit confused about gender. You know, it used to be male and female. That was it. Well, it's changing, and we're going to be talking with Dr. Ron Fishbeck, who taught health science and health education for years at Cal State Northridge. He'll be joining us in our next segment to talk about genders and what we call each other now, or what we can call each other now. To me, it doesn't matter, but I guess it does to some people. Our guest is Sassy Gregson-Williams. She is the founder of Naturally Sassy. We've been talking about her training, about food. You came up with an app which combines your recipes with your workout. So I can, if I travel, I can work out on my iPhone?
That is right. Yeah, you can stream on and offline. So the online studio started on computer, and you can stream it on Apple TV and things like that. But one of the most important things for me was just accessibility, because I think ballet has always been naturally pretty inaccessible, and felt like it was something that only the elite could do. And for me, it was really like boiling it down to being like, anybody can do this. You can benefit from the disciplines of ballet just, you know, by getting your phone and streaming with me.
Did you grow up in a ballet home? Did you go to see the Nutcracker every Christmas?
I did, and I was also dancing from the age of 3, so it was really my entire life. It was, you know, my life lesson, and my family were very supportive. I was a crazy child. I just wanted to dance, and I managed to kind of manipulate every situation, so dancing was my only education. By the age of about 14, I was only dancing. I'd managed to complete kind of all my exams you needed to complete, but a little bit older, and I got it done, so I could just only focus on the ballet. So discipline was everything to me from a very young age.
But you started a business. You were 16.
And I was, yeah.
And it's the same business.
It's the same business. It just really evolved. I started by doing lots of recipes for a health magazine in the UK, and I was about 15, and I was the food editor, and I didn't tell a single soul that I was only 15. I tried to speak what they wanted to hear. I told them that I was a lot older than I was, and I got the job, and I did a lot of recipes for them, and that's really where my backbone for cooking came from. I developed this passion outside of the walls of dance, which was pretty unfamiliar and rare for a dancer. Food and dancing didn't really go hand in hand. I was one of the only friends that I had that was, you know, into cooking or eating for that matter. And I developed a love of sharing what I was learning, because I was learning a lot about food and sport and the relationship between the two. And that's when I started Naturally Sassy, but it was a blog at the time. So it was just lots of recipes and nothing to do with ballet, because ballet was my escape. Food was my escape from ballet, even. Ballet was what I wanted to escape from. It was tough.
What about your family? Were they also into the healthy lifestyle of a ballet artist?
They were into the healthy lifestyle, not necessarily of ballerinas. I mean, my mum, from as far as I can remember, she was the most organic living pioneer of all time. She would stand at the supermarket waiting for them to get the organic ingredients in. So she was there right from the very beginning. And it's a real reflection, because now my brother is in health, and so is my sister. She runs a health magazine. So it obviously rubbed off on all of us. But then I went through my time as a dancer and as a young girl, which I think all dancers do, of being so utterly confused about what I was supposed to eat. I had no idea. I didn't eat for probably about 3-4 months at one point. I just like little nibbles here and there, because I was so affected by what other dancers were doing. And that's really when I was like, this is not good. You're not serving your body. Your body is your tool, and you're completely undernourishing it. And that is when the kind of light bulb moment happened for me, that, you know, food is fuel. And it's the biggest tool you have to perform well in the studio, but then just in overall life. So
but it was but really going, you know, bottom. I'm sorry, go ahead.
I know, it's just what I was saying was, it's just me hitting rock bottom with the way that I was eating, to kind of understand that I really needed to pick up my game and get get loving cooking and eating.
And living in Santa Monica, there's so many great restaurants, the Lobster, and there's Italian restaurants and all kinds of places. Can you eat out with your recipes, with your regimen?
Yes, absolutely. I'm very flexible with the way that I like. I mean, I'm very flexible with where I'll eat because there's always something on the menu, and people, particularly in Santa Monica or in big cities, are very flexible with what they'll do for you. So it's all about finding, for me at least, just the freshest ingredients on the menu, the ones that don't have slatherings of oil or butter, and just getting it really simple, and just asking. A lot of the time for me, I'll get, you know, a big beautiful salad, but know that the dressing is full of stuff that I don't want, and just ask for some simple olive oil and balsamic or something on the side, and people are really accommodating. So it's just about knowing that. I think a lot of the time food, the way that we eat food, is very emotional. It's an emotional response. When we eat lots of food or we overeat, it's because we're often, you know, either being pressured from our friends that are going to the Lobster too and eating all the food, and we're maybe not wanting to.
Right. We're out of time. Listen, everybody, if you go to latenighthealth.com, we'll have a picture of Sassy up there. What is your website?
It's
naturallysassy.co.uk. Naturallysassy.totaleating. And we'll have more information on Late Night Health. We're out of time. I got to go. Thank you, Sassy. We'll talk soon.
You're welcome.
I'm Mark Allen. We'll be right back. Don't go away.